So, now you know.
At once he looked weary, weary and old and decrepit.
Shouldn't you?
He gestured weakly with his hand. Yes, you're right. Thank you for the information thus far. Goodbye. He watched me cross the patio. Goodbye. And, Vam. I stopped. Yes?
If you see my wife, I hope you're not going to plague her with these things.
I smiled thinly. No, I wasn't intending to. I left him there in the warm glow of a new summer. He was an ambassador of the previous autumn, though, exiled in a foreign land and ready for sending home, but still enjoying the privileges of a kind of diplomatic status in life. As for me, I crossed the border to the Arboretum and wasn't stopped at passport control either. Chapter 26. I found them sitting on a bench by Lake Murka, which looked like a pond, but had a seemingly invisible overgrown connection with the fjord to the north. A cool, somber atmosphere hung over the place, like in a cathedral. It was as though you could still see the shadows of the ancient monks wandering among the trees, deep in meditation. Siv and her mother were staring at a little green island in the black water. Pines and birch trees grew on it, while around them the forest consisted of tall dark green spruce trees and Asiatic conifers of various kinds. A handful of dark red, almost burgundy water lilies were floating in the water, which emphasized the sacred feel of the place.